Let's say you want to shoot a film all by yourself. Just you, your camera, and a tripod. Then maybe this one's for you. In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can use fake camera movements in post to give your shots a more vivid and cinematic look. So let's start off by creating a new project in Premiere Pro. So let's add a clip to the media library. These are some shots I took today. And we take this one. Before you ask, all this was shot in 4K on the Sony A6300 in Cine 1 picture profile and graded with my Cine Vintage LUT. So here we have our 4K file. And let's drag it over to your timeline. Here we are now. So, and now we want to make the sequence smaller than the actual footage is, because we need the space of this image to move the image around. So let's go to sequence settings. And as you see, you have a 4K frame size here. And let's make it 1080. Now the footage is zoomed in for sure, because it is bigger than your sequence. So let's go to the effect controls to animate our first zoom in effect. Select the clip. And here we are. So what we're doing now is adding keyframes to animate the image. If we type in 50 here, the 4K image gets back to the original size. So let's add a keyframe here at scale, at 50, at the first frame of our clip. So let's stop here, cut it, and go to the last frame of your clip. Now you can type in any number here, and the image will animate to this frame size. So let's say 60, hit enter, and you see there's another keyframe at the last frame, and we have our keyframe at the first frame. And that's it. You made your first zoom effect. So let's try it with another example of, let's say, this one. So drag it over to the timeline. And now we want to add a pan effect, so that the image keeps moving from left to right or right to left or from up to down. Again, we go to the first frame. But before we animate the video, we're gonna scale it a bit down, so we have that space we need. Let's say 60 again. Move it a bit up, so everything is in frame. Till now, you haven't set any keyframes. This was just positioning the image as we want it to be. And now we're going to make it move from left to right. So, remember we are on the first frame. And let's play around with the settings at position. You can see we have a bit of space here we can use. So, let's leave it here. Add a new keyframe. Go to your last frame. And move it around again. Say to here. As you see, two new keyframes. And we're done. And a cool thing about this technique is I think that you can play around with all these settings and use different kinds of motions and scalings, rotations, and let's do another one with rotation. So let's take this one. And let's try it with rotation. So here's our first frame. And so it's a bit too big, I think, so let's get it down to 70 or so. Yes, and now we want to rotate this image. So first we want to play around with this setting here to see in which degree the image doesn't fit into this size anymore. So, yeah. So we can leave it at minus 12 and set a keyframe again. Go to the end of the clip. And let's rotate it by plus 13. And here we have our really stable rotation without any camera movement. So let's say you want to add a zoom effect on this one also. First frame. Add another keyframe at scale. Go to the end. So this time we want to zoom in by 10. So type in 80, hit enter. And you have just combined rotation effect with a scaling effect. To make it more cinematic, you can now just grade it a bit. I just do it real quick. And last, put some music on it. And that's it. If you have any questions, put it in the comments down below. I will try to reply to them soon as I can. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And also make sure to check out my Instagram, where I do a lot of photography and filmmaking stuff. So if you're into this, subscribe to my channel and see you next time. Bye.